Bloke with a very healthy interest in you. You want to stay well away from him.
He must get her to him.
It's about your Steve. Apparently he's in a bit of trouble.
What do you mean? What kind of trouble?
Is this a trap with her son as bait?
And if Fraser really is just using Steve to get to you?
That's the risk I've just got to take.
Drawn deeper into his clutches. Coronation Street continues tonight, 7:30.
Next tonight on LWT, we join ITN for today's news and sport.
All over Britain, more people will be able to save in the double discount sale from today, including New Year's Day at DFS. Not only is everything reduced, everything's free for a year too. Take 3 years free credit and pay nothing for the first year. We're even doubling the sale discount on many items. This leather settee is only £5.99. This settee is only £4.99. Sale prices, double discount, 3 years free credit, and everything free for a year from today, including New Year's Day at DFS.
Maybe I didn't treat you quite as good as I should have. Maybe I didn't love you quite as often as I could have. Little things I should have said and done, I just never took the time. You were always on my mind. You were always on my mind.
Mama mi se voy, piani mi se voy, io son l'amor che svanisce, ma dei baci miei.
Biggest computer sale is now on at PC World.
A really big sale.
With the biggest choice of famous name PCs.
Massive savings.
And our best ever sale prices.
Biggest sale ever.
We're in the world.
PC World's biggest ever computer sale. Now on.
Not only is everything reduced, there's many double discounts and 3 years free credit with nothing to pay for the first year. That's DFS from today, including New Year's Day.
From the new year, Emmerdale's now on...
Three times a week.
This is our little secret.
That's right.
We're on three times a week now.
It should be interesting.
Brilliant. Three times a week.
When I were young, there were no such thing.
I wouldn't want you to miss it.
What is it?
One, two,
three. Things will never be the same again, will they?
From the new year... on Carlton.
The youngsters of today, eh? What they like?
You're watching LWT.
From the studios of ITN, the news with Nicholas Owen.
Good evening, welcome to the programme. The headlines: a couple die trying to rescue their dog from a frozen lake. And the siege in Peru, hopes rise for a peaceful end. A middle-aged couple died today, apparently trying to rescue their pet Labrador dog from a frozen lake in Essex. William and Jill Willis fell through the ice at Belhurst Wood Country Park near Grays. Two people who tried to rescue them are being treated in hospital for hypothermia. Helen Wright reports.
On the scene within minutes, fire and police rescue teams fought for hours to try and save the couple. William Willis, a self-employed decorator, was trapped beneath the ice for over 2 hours. Paramedics could do nothing to save him. They tried to revive his wife of 30 years, Jill, when she was pulled from the water. She died later in hospital. Another couple who tried to help the Willises were also overcome by the cold. Park rangers managed to save them. They hope others will learn from the tragedy.
It must be a lesson to anyone that takes a dog out by a lake this time of the year to keep it on a lead if you know it's going to go in the water. And if it does go in the water, whatever you do, don't go on the ice. If you don't know how thick the ice is going to be or how deep the water is. Once you've gone through the ice, you become a victim yourself and someone else may perish trying to rescue you.
Tara, the pet the couple doted on, managed to scramble out of the lake by herself. Fire officers say owners must realise dogs are resilient and they should leave any rescue attempt to the professionals.
Call the fire service, we've got the gear to do it, and we can rescue a dog, and we'd much sooner try rescuing a dog than a human being.
The man and woman who so nearly lost their own lives in this frozen lake as they tried to save the lives of others both needed treatment for hypothermia. Tonight their condition is still being monitored closely by doctors. Helen Wright, ITN, Essex.
Negotiators are hopeful that the hostage crisis in the Peruvian capital Lima will end soon. Rebel guerrillas are still holding 83 people inside the Japanese ambassador's residence in Lima, but say they want to negotiate a settlement. It follows the release of 20 captives yesterday. From Lima, Howell Jones reports.
Patience has paid off for the man who's helped to free the hostages in Lima. He says the talks that led to the latest mass release could be just the start.
I think that everybody, not inside but also outside, was glad that some discussion was going on. And it makes sense.
Last night, 20 men waved goodbye to those still trapped inside the ambassador's residence, but their release was not easily won. For the first time, the Peruvian government had face-to-face talks with the terrorists. The Peruvian Education Minister, Domingo Palermo,